What is up, Jamily? This is JamiroFan 2000 here with yet another episode of JamiroFan Talks About, where I look at the past, present, and future of JamiroQuai's music, their history, and everything JamiroQuai related over the last 27 years of their history. In this episode, I thought I'd change things up and specifically talk about merchandise or clothing. Now, we know JamiroQuai in the past has had very loose partnerships, at least in the regards to their clothing lines, with originally when they signed with Sony back in 1993, they had a management company called Arenda, who did produce some very rare tour jackets during that time. And of course, they also had a partnership with Levi Strauss, who also did some of their denim jackets for their tours. Now, we did recently see examples of JamiroQuai, or specifically JK, doing partnerships with Louis Vuitton and with Kurt Geiger. Now we know that JamiroQuai does do all of their merchandise in-house. That means through JamiroQuai Limited. And some fans in the Jamily have been a little dismayed by some of the merchandise offerings, at least from the modern, during the last few modern album eras. So in this episode of JamiroFan Talks About, I thought I'd talk about what companies members of the Jamily would like to see JamiroQuai partner up with to do exclusive clothing lines for the Jamily specifically, or for JamiroQuai fans, old and new. And if we used an album era as an example of clothing lines, we could use two JamiroQuai album periods as examples of when JamiroQuai did do partnerships. And as I prefaced at the beginning of this video, JamiroQuai did start it out in the first few albums doing partnerships with Levi Strauss and, of course, Arenda. Down the road, JamiroQuai would do a partnership with Fila, which was during Traveling Without Moving, and, of course, they would reconnect with Levi Strauss when they put out during Canned Heat. JK was wearing a limited edition Levi Strauss Silver Tab, which had the two hole sleeve on it, and those jackets were very sought after by members of the Jamily, but were very limited number in the numbers they were made. I believe there's only two colored versions of that jacket that were for sale. One was a teal, and then of course there was the red one that were for sale. But then thereafter, JamiroQuai didn't do a lot of merchandise, at least clothing merchandise, outside of independent retailers and artists making their own clothing. And you look at the modern internet these days, at least for merchandise, there's a lot of JamiroQuai merchandise that is sold outside of the official merchandising and licensing. If you go to eBay or any of these online retail websites, a lot of JamiroQuai clothing and merchandise is not then licensed. There's a lot of like T-shirt designs and everything. You could go to Amazon, you're gonna find a lot of this. A lot of these silkscreen T-shirts that have not been licensed by JamiroQuai official, or at least in this case, JamiroQuai Limited. So, quite literally, any Tom, Dick, and Harry can make their own JamiroQuai merchandise. But I do think, at least for the next album cycle, the clothing that JamiroQuai put out for Automaton, and of course the second album era that I was going to talk about with an example of JamiroQuai merchandise, was of course this most recent 3 years from 2017 to 2019 of the Automaton album era. We did have some great, pretty awesome T-shirt designs, and of course the Automaton tour jacket come out. But that stuff all did sell out very quickly. And then we did see a second tier of JamiroQuai merchandise, clothing, official clothing, come out in Japan in a partnership with the Co high-end clothing distributor. So they did license JamiroQuai in Japan and did sell some very limited, cool-looking merchandise there in Japan. Most significantly, they brought this stuff out around when JamiroQuai was on tour for Automaton initially in 2017, and had that all for sale at the Co shop. But ultimately, you know, that stuff would end up selling out again too. So I honestly, at least in my opinion, I would love to see JamiroQuai rehook up with Adidas. JamiroQuai have worn Adidas for many, many decades and many, many years, and we most recently saw that Adidas is starting to do partnerships with notable mainstream musicians and celebrities for new upcoming clothing lines. Specifically, Pharrell Williams is a good example. Most recently, they just signed a deal with Beyonce, and of course, one with Childish Gambino. I think JK is smart enough, as a businessman to know to pick the right deals that come across the table. And I think to make JamiroQuai's merchandise more accessible, because honestly, the Automaton era, most of the fashion lines that have come out from JamiroQuai, at least in partnership with other third parties that made and manufactured their merchandise, it was very, very limited. And I know a lot of fans are, you know, had to hunt a lot of this merchandise down. I know I hunted a lot of it down. I do think JamiroQuai, at least for their next album, which will be their ninth, not counting High Times, but I think for their ninth album, I think they should hook up with a very, very good clothing high-end or medium-end clothing retailer to have JK design some really cool, more accessible JamiroQuai merchandise, fully licensed. Because a lot of merchandise out there, be it at live gigs, be it online, as I said, which is probably one of the biggest attractors of people buying JamiroQuai merchandise, at least licensed JamiroQuai merchandise, they need to go with a stable fashion company that knows how to market and can sell it at a very reasonable price. So I would love to see JamiroQuai, at least for the ninth album cycle, hook up with Adidas. Not saying Adidas isn't expensive, but Adidas really have dropped their prices on a lot of the stuff. And on some of the celebrity, like I said, clothing lines that have most recently been signed and are starting to come out sometime this fall, which will be the Beyonce and the Childish Gambino lines. The Pharrell clothing line has been out for about a year now. But I think a JamiroQuai clothing line designed by the band or by JK or by some of the brilliant people there at Adidas would be awesome and would help further get merchandise out from JamiroQuai much, much easier and at a faster pace, rather than doing a flood of fans going onto an official website, say adidas.com, and buying it all up. And then there's always that situation where third parties could buy up all the merchandise and then hawk them out on eBay for either a profit or a reduced profit. So, I'd love to see the JamiroQuai hook up with Adidas, to be honest, to do an exclusive clothing line, either for the European market or for the U.S. market, or make it worldwide, or maybe just do Japan like they did with Co. for the Automaton era, and come up with some cool new merchandise. But I'm most interested in your opinion. Who do you want to see JamiroQuai hook up with in a possible merchandising official clothing line deal with? I mean, there's a lot of competition out there for Adidas. You could go Puma. You could go, maybe they could go back to Levi Strauss. It would be really cool to see them full circle and go back to Levi Strauss too, maybe for some torque jackets or something. But I know how all these artists want to keep everything in house so they can maximize their profitability and maximize their revenue streams. But who would you like to see JamiroQuai hook up with for a potential ninth album merchandise clothing fashion line? I would prefer Adidas, but I'm most interested in hearing your opinions on who you'd like to see JamiroQuai partner up with for a potential fashion line in the next album cycle going into 2020 and 2021. Please be sure to leave your comments, your opinions, and everything down into the YouTube comment section in this video down below. And of course, I'll be posting this video on the JamiroQuai subreddit, so feel free to leave your feedback and thoughts about this discussion topic in the comment section of this post on the JamiroQuai subreddit. I look forward to reading all of your great feedback to this post question here on this episode of JamiroFan Talks About. Thank you again, everyone, for all the support of all of my videos here on YouTube. And, of course, there's going to be definitely more content coming into my channel over the next few weeks as we go up to the as we come back to JamiroQuai going back on tour again in their 2019 European Summer Music Festival, capping off on the weekend of May 11th, of course, at the Mallorca Live Festival in Mallorca, Spain. So expect all the usual coverage on the JamiroQuai subreddit in real time, and of course a day after with my video recap of every respective tour date of that tour. And as always, this is JamiroFan 2000, and I'll see you again really soon with another JamiroFan Talks About, another JamiroQuai Minute, and all more JamiroQuai related videos here on the JamiroFan 2000 YouTube channel. Bye-bye, everybody.